It's one without. It's shine season. Yeah. Black. Black. Black is beautiful, baby. Black is bold. Black is black, true, but black is gold. No. Hey. Hey. Yeah. Look. I said black is beautiful, shawty. Black is bold. Black is black, true, but black is gold. Hey, let's do it. Look, black is beautiful, shawty, that you should know. Don't let American standards damage your African soul.
Welcome to Street Education. This is a platform where we educate the streets, and it's surrounding like different topics. Today, the topic is actually black beauty. We've got four young people here. So both me and Simone will be asking the questions and seeing what their perspective is.
So you could all start by introducing yourself, what's your name?
My name's Drips, and when I'm older, I'd like want to be an entrepreneur, like in clothing and marketing.
My name's Trinity.
My name's Jayden, and when I'm older, I want to be an entrepreneur, and I want to bring up my own clothing line called YP. It stands for Young Production, and it's trying to help people to be young entrepreneurs and boost them when they're older to them, so they can be good businessmen.
My name's Kashae and I'm trying to be a lawyer.
So I'm Simona, I'm here with Jay today for the More Lions. You know me from One, Opportunities Near Everyone. So yeah, we've got these four beautiful black people here today with us to speak about black beauty. I think Jay, you're asking the first question.
Yeah, so the first question is, how comfortable are you in your black skin?
If we start that with Drips.
I'm comfortable. I think society's made it a little bit easier to be black recently, compared to like some people like Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and stuff. It's made like it's not quite a weird thing anymore. Like everyone's quite together, but there's obviously some people who make comments like calling people niggers and stuff. Like it's like quite a casual thing. When I think like it should be more of like it should really be something that's said so casually and so humanely.
I feel like I'm comfortable with my skin within myself, but then obviously like it's different if you're surrounded by, and trying to mean like in different environments, obviously makes you feel like a different kind of way, especially when you're surrounded by people that aren't like it, or they don't understand or want to understand what you're like.
Sorry, can I just say for the camera, because obviously none of you are aware, this is the first time you're meeting Trinity. She was very clever as a child, so she had the opportunity to go to a very expensive, exclusive school. It's called Trinity College. Google it, you'll see. Trent College. If you Google it, you'll see the fees are ridiculous. I think in education there's about £70,000, am I right? And she had that privilege to go there for a full term of secondary education. So I think that's why she means sometimes in different environments, because that was a majority white environment, wasn't it, Trinity?
Yeah.
Yeah, so that obviously would have had an impact on how she felt in her skin.
Jayden? I'm comfortable with my skin, happy with it, but there's sometimes when like you're in class and then they'll be talking about slavery and then everyone's just looking at you like you could be the only black boy in your class, and then it just makes you feel the type of way.
So that relates kind of what to what Trinity said, it's when you're in an environment, I'd say majority white environment, is that fair to say, guys?
No.
So when you're the minority, that's when you feel the type of way for the colour of your skin. Interesting. Kashae?
I like being black personally, I want to be darker. I just like it, but it's just awkward when people like they judge you straight. You can tell you're being judged straight away. Like when you're in a white environment, for example, slavery thing again always happens. You just feel like the minority basically.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I love being black. I'd never want to change it, but
if I had a choice, I'd definitely.
I'd never want to be black myself. Myself's too black.
Myself. Took them out of the island.
I don't like myself. Like a t-shirt.
It's sad, isn't it?
Like, well, I was broke.
You know what the video is at night time, you just can't see the body. It's just body.
No, I don't think it's really that bad.
It's a ghost.
Actually, it's so rude.
For us, we believe the black of the berry, the sweet of the juice, so I actually think Marcel's quite cool.
Right.
Shout
out Machiavelli's birthday yesterday.
Oh, yeah. Shout out to Tupac. But okay, so.
To me, it was my birthday as well, of course.
Oh, yes, of course, indeed. So, yeah, so the second question is, you say you're comfortable, all of you more or less said you're happy being black, but in a white environment, it makes you feel kind of different. And this is something that was happening in South Africa. I don't know how much you guys know about black politics, but the kids weren't allowed to wear their hair, their natural black hairstyles there. So I noticed that both of you here today have natural hair. You're wearing it really freely and really beautifully, both of you. But there are other places of the world, like South Africa, where you couldn't go to school with your hair like this. And we spoke about schooling and being the minority. How do you girls and boys, I see your hair's looking quite straight, is that a natural effect there? Or, you know, is that, you know, something that you've infused? Tell me about how you feel with your hairs and how comfortable you are with black hair.
First of all, can I say something? This was an accident. Second of all, it was her fault. So I don't know why she had to open the camera. Third of all, yeah, I was happy with my hair, but I wanted it more curly. Now, the reason I wanted it curly because I think I felt peer pressured into it. Because, like, when I was going to barber shop and my hair just looked hard and rough, and then everyone else's hair, like, even my uncles and my cousins' hair was all curly and, like, texturized and stuff. Yeah, man, when you see something a lot, it makes you want to be like that, like you feel like left out. So like when you want to be part of something else, then like, you feel pressured, like you have to be part of it, or like you're not complete or something. So I think that was one of the reasons why I wanted to do it.
Brilliant answer, but just, I think, and Jaya, please also say, do you not think that's so sad for our youths? That yeah. They feel pressured into doing something that really is to make them more white.
I was thinking of asking, like, I don't know what school you to go to, but in some schools, like you got Trinity,
yes.
Trinity School, down in Aspen, literally boys can't have the hair, Cambridge.
Brilliant example.
Or they can't have, they have to have it like a certain,
it's got to be, they can't have an afro, can like, they? Yeah.
And like you get put in isolation just for having your hair a certain way.
Yes.
So that's in our school as well, if it's a certain colour you can't have it either, or like, if it's like, if you have like a pattern in it or like too puffy, you call it an extreme hairstyle.
Yeah.
And I feel like this is all a control mechanism, because it's always going to control people, you can't be free. Like, if they're not controlling you, like literally slaving you, then they're gonna control you through your hair, through what you're eating, through what you're watching, through what you're programming. So it's all control. Even at school, the teachers are controlling you. You can't do certain things. You can't go to the toilet without asking. You can't even drink water without asking.
Okay, Trinity, how do you feel with your hair? Your hair's big and absolutely gorgeous. How do you feel being in that white environment at Trent? Was it something that you was, you know, easy to fit in with? Is it something that you find challenging?
No, yeah, I love my hair. Like, I love it. But I just feel like sometimes, even like when you have your natural hair, girls are still pressured to like make your edges all slick, do you know what I mean? When like naturally,
yeah.
Like your hair's gonna twist a little bit and it's gonna come out, do you know what I mean? And I feel like as well, what Kamal was saying, yeah. Schools do definitely de-individualise people through their hair. Like I remember I couldn't even have braids at school because it was like an extreme hairstyle.
Right.
Do you know what I mean? But like, with white girls with two Dutch parts, that's fine.
Yes.
Like, I feel like not only is that rude, but it's just so hurtful, do you know what I mean? Because like that's obviously my culture and just disrespecting it because I, a black person, can't have it, yet these white people can.
Brilliant.
I definitely
example.
Think that's rude.
I think that is an absolutely brilliant point that you've made.
I said another thing.
Take that a bit further.
Like, my hair now, when it's short, it looks straight, but if my hair looks like Afro or something like Jayden's, then people might say, oh, your hair looks pepper green or stuff like that.
Yes.
Like, why is it pepper green? It's just
yes.
Afro. It's the way I am. You've got a problem.
Brilliant.
You've got a problem with your address for me. Like.
Yeah.
Like, you're going to say pepper green. What's pepper greens?
I think again it comes back to.
I don't even have
I think there's coming back. No, you've got lovely waves, but I think the point that he's making is if it doesn't look very white, it's not that nice.
Like, if it doesn't look wavy, they're gonna say pepper green. They're gonna say you look dusty.
And obviously that's a mixed race like kind of white style, isn't it? Because like Trinity said, black people we naturally our hair naturally curls up. You know, even if we slick it in the morning, my fringe is a prime example. By the end of the show, it might be puff. You know, you can press it in the morning, but it reverts back. Do you know what I mean? And the reverting isn't seen as pretty. My fringe looks nice. Everyone says it's pen when it's straight. When it does start to puff, I've been called a monkey. Funnily enough.
The worst thing is, it's like a natural thing. It's not like you're like this. I was trying to get like a certain look out of it.
Yeah.
When your hair goes puffy, it's a natural thing. It's how you wake up.
Yeah, so. And they make our natural, I suppose, seem ugly. Brilliant, brilliant. Jayden, how do you feel about your hair?
I feel fine. My hair's nice.
You said you're so confident today, I love it. Have you ever had a problem with your hair? Have you ever been called pepper green head or anything personally?
No, but I think I got called picky there one time.
Right.
Obviously then, that's like peer pressure, man, to go get my hair cut, because that's making me feel a type of way at myself, that, like, because I was trying to grow it.
Right.
Like, so that's why I didn't go get a haircut, because I wanted an afro. And then people were like, were saying stuff, so obviously I thought, oh no, love that. And then I've gone and get my hair cut, innit?
So your hair was being called picky when it was growing in its afro state?
Well, by one person, by one person.
Yeah, 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 fair enough. But it still was because you was growing it. But when it's short, it's okay. It's quite nice and wavy short. Okay, so again, that affected how you've kept your hair. Do you know what I mean? Because like you said, if you wasn't called picky hair by that one person, you might have a big, beautiful afro now. Mm. Yeah, it's deep.
Yeah, it's actually quite mad how one person's perspective when you can like completely damage your like perception of yourself. Yeah. The one question I hate, yeah, is, oh, like if you have like four hair extensions in or something, it'll be like, oh, I'll rip your weave out, or...
And then what, can I touch it?
Or, what's
that your hair?
How long's your real hair? Like, fam, like, Jayden yesterday, this, he said, oh, you need your natural hair out.
Why are you my natural hair,
Jayden? Natural hair, everyone just, like, society just assumes black people
have fake hair.
Yeah, like, and there's this girl at my school, and her hair's disgusting, she's always wearing weave, and I've never heard anybody say anything to her. But as soon as we come in with our long braids or something, it's like, just... A problem. It's a problem. Yeah. You've always got something to say.
Always. I don't think credit
Jayden,
I like black braids, yeah. Natural, like no makeup on it. Real hair,
yeah.
Natural. It's natural,
yeah.
Yes, yeah. No,
let's hear them out.
You get them black girls, yeah. All the sway. Their head got patches and then it's weaving. Boy, they're wearing fake hair anyway. It's Muslim hair anyway, so yeah. I don't know what they're doing. Trying to act like it's their real hair and everything, you know, but I ain't saying nothing.
They bought it, it's their hair.
They're hair. Someone else's hair, it's not their hair.
They bought it.
So that leads us on to the next question, because the next question is...
Well, the third question is, I think you are black and beautiful. Is that something you believe and can say?
Of course, without a doubt.
You can't. Okay, so how does it relate though? Because you say...
When it comes to the whole black thing, like inside sometimes it's cool, like people like Leo, and like, they're saying like, oh come on, look at you, look how black you are, look, you're so black.
Yeah.
So I'm saying,
and you're not really dark at all.
I'm not like,
that
if you look at my skin, people call me light skin, I've got this hair.
Yeah.
And when they call you like, come on, you're black, like I'm saying, what's wrong with that? It's like almost like being black, like something bad, like something wrong, something ugly.
So can you say freely, so the question again was, can you say freely, I am black and I am beautiful? Not just like, oh, I'm beautiful. Can you say you're black and beautiful? Or is that something that you can't express?
I
can
do that.
Society is thinking out loud to be beautiful.
And if you're black, I'm black.
I'm black. I'm black and beautiful because a lot of people are like, well, I'm white, can I be beautiful too?
Being
beautiful just in general though, like, someone get a compliment this and be like, oh my god, no, no.
They
shy away.
Yeah. Like you say that you're beautiful and people try to say that you're vain or like you're egotistical or something like that. But really it's more about having self-confidence, and like sometimes when people say, oh, the whole black thing, like it's a little bit like try to say, oh, so what if you're white or something like that, but I'm saying people try to say that you act like you're discriminating when you say that you're black. So like if I say, oh, I'm talking to my black friend, then people say, oh, why are you discriminating white people and stuff like that? It's just not a thing like that. Sometimes it's like black brother connections, like black brother always family all the time. Like, if you ever see a black person, you'll go to them and they just know what to do. Like, if you're not a black person, you're not black.
Yeah,
it's like a thing that black
people. Yeah, that's like why thing. People feel like just because they don't have it, then they're like,
oh, yeah, exactly. So take that away from them.
What if you think you're black and you're beautiful and you know it and you can happily feel it, like, oh, I rate you.
100%, I rate you.
So you, is that something then that you can't do then? So shall I ask that question again?
No, I can say it to myself, but I can probably say it to Kashae.
Can you say this? Could you stand in your school playground and say this?
No, 100%. They'll say, come on, you're black and you're ugly. They'll say, drip shot, you're a black egg. That's what you're
So can we say one at a time? So you're saying no, you couldn't say it. Trinity, no. Jayden.
I couldn't.
Jayden, you couldn't, man. You get pissed off.
I don't care. So what? I don't go outside just to hear what they're going to say about me. I'm free, innit, man? Come on.
No, you never catch me saying that.
So you said you could say it in front of...
Yeah, I could say it to Kashae.
So have you not got friends like...
Oh no, yeah, definitely do. Like,
but I'm saying in the playground,
well, yeah, like,
it's
like,
everyone. Like, would happen in school. More time you get
attention. Because me and my girls are definitely caught.
More time teachers don't like me. Most time they'll put me in isolation. Come on, you make people feel discriminated, intimidated. You know what I mean? Make people feel uncomfortable. Make people feel ugly. They'll make up words. They'll call me Arafazata or something like that.
Oh, brilliant.
Right, so the last question is, how, like, this is for the boys, how do you view black girls? Like, what's your thoughts on black girls?
I think natural for a black girl is quite rare though, now in this day and age. I think natural for any girl is quite rare.
No, I think black girls are quite
natural. Not embracing it now.
Is that the problem now?
Embracing it more now.
Yeah. 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 I feel like they don't care. Like, your opinion doesn't matter.
Yeah, I feel like just because a girl wears makeup doesn't mean that she's not natural. Do you know what I mean? Like, right now I'm still wearing makeup, but I would happily leave my house on a Thursday with their makeup on to go to town. Yes.
I think black people just have better skin anyway. Like, they don't actually need it.
A lot of these girls, yeah. They're just slapping on makeup because everyone else is slapping on makeup. Like, some people, you know, some people that just don't need makeup, but putting it on because their friends are putting it on, stuff
like
that.
It's like a trend though.
Yeah, it's like a trend. It's like some man that wears skinny jeans because next people wear skinny jeans. Or like some people wear True Religion because other people are wearing True Religion. Like, you don't always have to do what everyone else is doing. Like, people are like, a lot of people are sheeps. They're just following people. And like, I think people need to be their own person.
Definitely. So can I just say one thing? This wasn't a question that I planned, but it's something that I just feel to say from the conversation and the comments that you guys have said. And when I was growing up, I was called so much big lips. I went to a white school, Arnold Hill was the school. There weren't even much black people in Knots at that time. And I was a bit more of a Jayden. I didn't care what anybody had to say. I had a big brother. My big brother was like, you know, road man. He was out there. He always had the bummest gal and he always just told me I was beautiful. So I didn't really care. But so it didn't affect me growing up is the point that I'm trying to make. But as an adult, having children of my own and on reflection, I see, or this is how I feel, which is really like what you guys are saying, that for me, it's okay for white people to have big lips. I don't know what made me think of this is Kylie Jenner. I don't know if you know, but Kylie Jenner has Botox in her lips. She has really big lips now. She's, you know, this famous icon, and she has the lips as her brand, as her logo for her brand, these big lips. But when I was growing up, my big lips were scorned upon. But now, because a white girl has got it and it's socially now beautiful, it's accepted. In LA, they spend over 2.3 million a year on Botox treatments, okay? And this is all to have bigger lips. So what I feel it is, and please guys, you are the young people, you're the next generation, so you know, tell me if my feeling's right, but I feel like black is beautiful, but only when it's made white. And social media, like the French plait that Trinity said, you know, girls can have French plaits at school, it's okay for them. I actually seen an Indian girl with braids over there. I was like, what? When did Indians braid their hair? Do you know what I mean? She looked cute, baby hairs all on fleek and all that. Do you know what I mean? And she was full Indian. So it's okay to be black as long as you're not black.
Yeah.
Wrong or right?
I'll say, I'm just telling you, this is happening here. This is exactly what's happening. It's the white girls and the black boys. Then the black girls go for the white boys, but the white boys don't like the black girls, so the black girls acting white.
You're just speaking it, you're just waffling it. That's not even true.
That's true, I'm just.
How is that true?
100%.
No,
that's not true.
No, 100%. White girls are definitely kind of taking black girls because they do more, that they act more black now. But black girls. Black girls still go for black guys.
I would never go for a black girl. I like white girls only.
That's true. That's guys. You said black girls. Like a lot of black guys say that.
I know a lot of black girls.
There is a lot of black girls that go for white guys, and that's simply because they have experienced the black guy and they don't like the way the black guy is.
Yeah.
So they will go for something, they think, oh, I'll have a better life with a white guy. But
yeah.
Except for
you know what, yeah, no, it's just...
Don't think people
I just want to ask you, it's me one at a time.
No, do you know what it is, yeah?
some black guys now see girls, like black girls, and oh, there's so much drama involved, they're so loud, it's all this, yeah. all that.
Stigma, it's called. Black girls are now stigmatized.
I feel like it changes. I feel like at the moment, I feel like black girls are being super hypersexualized. Like if you look online, like you see so many pictures of just like gorgeous, just thick black girls, just like all oiled up and just dripping, honey. Like obviously it's gorgeous.
Yeah.
But like when you think, like people are looking at her and thinking that she's beautiful, but only when she's naked and just strips and honey. Do you know what I mean? Like not to say that she's not beautiful then, because obviously she is. But I feel like black girls are definitely super hypersexualized at the moment. Mm-hmm. Like I feel like just because you're going for a black girl, you're not going for her attributes. You're going because you think that she's sexy, or you think other people think that she's sexy. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
She helps to boost your ego.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Definitely.
Absolutely brilliant. Yeah. Drips, Trinity, Jayden, Kashae, JR, this has been an absolute pleasure speaking with you all today. Thank you. Keep checking it out. Street Education. It's the More Lions, the Kingdom spot that we're at today. Don't forget me, the one. Opportunities near everyone. Thank you for tapping in. One love.
I love the snack.
Is that it?
Yeah, more power, more love, more unity, you with me? Because that's what it's about, more life, you with me? More education to the youths, them. Each one teach one, because we need to make the youths, them know what time is at. It's all about black beauty, huh? More black beauty, that's what we're trying to educate the youths, them with. On the streets, yeah. So obviously they can know their inner beauty and know their value, know that they're the greatest. Yeah, love thyself, know thyself. So shout out to the sisters, yeah? And all the youngsters what came into the ask of his kingdom spot. So shout out to little sis, you mean JJ, you mean Simona, you've got Drips, you've got Jada, Trinity, Kashae, you mean. So shout out to all the little people, all the big people. Let's keep the powers up, you mean, because that's what it's about. More power, more love, and more life for the youngsters, you mean. Yeah, one order, street education, yeah. Come down to Kingdom and Spot, get involved. One love.
An architect, doctor, maybe an actress, but nothing comes easy. It takes much practice. Like I met a woman who's becoming a star.